So the funny thing is that I never planned to quit alcohol. You know, I've always been into doing challenges and always been into self-improvement. And so I decided to go a couple of months without any drinking. And that's exactly what I did. And to be totally honest, the very thought of never drinking again really scared me. I mean, it was like, what, you know, never, like, I don't, you know, who am I going to be? What am I going to say? What am I going to do? You know, am I going to go on dates, this, that? It just totally kind of freaked me out. And so I never told myself, you know what, I'm never going to drink again. But something interesting happened over the past year. So, like I said, I went a couple of months without alcohol. And I started to, and as the time went on, I started to see the light. I started to see the truth and started to realize, wow, you know, I can totally have fun without drinking. You know, I love that every single Sunday morning, I wake up with energy. And in fact, I'm able to wake up early on Sunday mornings and, you know, go for long bike rides and, you know, gardening and just crush the day with chores, where for most of my life, Sunday was a day of nursing a hangover, you know, waking up and, you know, just feeling like death and, you know, just like barely being able to get breakfast. And then I would find, especially as I got older, that it would last usually for days, you know, that one night of binge drinking on Saturday night, that hangover would last for days. And so as the time went on, as the months went on, it's still, the very thought of never drinking scared me. And so I, you know, that wasn't even like a thought in my head. But time went on, you know, a couple of months turned into about 6 months. And, you know, and I still was going out. I still decided to go out, opportunities when it was like a friend's birthday or something. They wanted to go out to the bar, sure, I'd go out, join them. You know, just have water, and a lot of people wouldn't even notice. You know, I wouldn't make a big deal out of it. You know, if anybody kind of caught on, I would just kind of brush it under the table. Oh, you know, I'm just, you know, I'm not drinking right now, maybe a little bit later. And I would just always kind of have ways to like sneakily push it off. And then they would forget as the night progressed. And what I started to find was that I could go out and I could have a good time. I could have fun without needing to drink alcohol. That, you know, I could still socialize and I could still be funny and laugh. And in the beginning, it was a little bit of a challenge because it was kind of awkward. You know, it was actually kind of awkward. You know, being out where everybody's drinking at a bar or, you know, a party, a wedding, where everybody else is getting drunk. And that's usually what I used to do. And in the beginning, it was kind of awkward. So it's kind of like retraining my brain how to, you know, how to be like a kid again, how to be able to socialize like a kid at a birthday party. They don't need any alcohol to have fun. You know, a kid at a park, they'll just go run up, starts talking to strangers, and, you know, in 5 minutes, they're best friends. You know, they're running all around and stuff like that. So I had to retrain my brain, you know, how to be able to have fun and laugh and connect and still, you know, have conversations without needing to, you know, get a buzz from drinking alcohol. And so as I started to get illuminated, I started to realize, wow, you know what, this is actually pretty easy. And I kept saying, you know, why don't we go a little bit longer? You know, I've already gone this long. Why don't you just see, you know, go a little bit longer? It was almost kind of like I didn't want to break the streak. And so about eight months went by where I didn't have any alcohol. And then all of a sudden, there was a festival going on in my town. And so I went out by myself and I decided to have a couple drinks. I guess I wasn't counting the days. And when I did, I remember I regretted it. And the next couple of days, I just felt horrible. And I said, wow, you know, why did I do that? Because I had gotten so used to feeling so good for so long that all of a sudden, when I finally did get that hangover again, and I felt, you know, and I had gotten so used to, you know, just operating at a peak level and having awesome energy and just being dialed in all the time without being slowed down by alcohol, but that finally, that one evening, when I didn't even get like wasted. I just had, you know, a couple of drinks, a couple of craft beers, which, you know, those are pretty strong. But for the next couple of days, it took me a couple of days to get back to myself again. And after that, I said, you know what? It's just not worth it anymore. And I still didn't say, you know what, I'm never drinking again. But as the time went on, I got back into that feeling great again state again. And just as we said, you know what, this is life. You know, this is living. You know, I want to feel like this all the time. And that's basically how my attitude has become. I still have never said that, you know what, I'm never having a drink again. But the thing is, my paradigm has completely shifted, where I have changed the way that I've looked at alcohol. From seeing it, you know, we've been conditioned from the time that we're young that alcohol is this sexy thing that, you know, is sophisticated and, you know, hey, the adults are, you know, drinking wine and so fancy, or you know, real man at the barbecue drinking beer and everything like that. You know, we've been conditioned. We see it in every single movie. You always see the macho guy, you know, you can just name about any movie, and you always see, you know, the macho guy slamming down shot after shot, drinking beer, going to the bars. You know, we've been conditioned, and so I've retrained myself the way that I look at, you know what, alcohol isn't this sexy thing. It's not this sophisticated thing. What it is, it's a toxin. It's a poison. I've researched a lot more into it to learn about the truth of what alcohol really is. The name alcohol comes from the Arabic term alkul, which means body-eating spirit, which is exactly what it is. It's a toxin. It's a poison. There's a reason why they call spirits spirits, and booze booze, because when you drink it, literally, it's said that your spirit is leaving your body. And you know what, I'm very much into health. I love to work out every day. I love to eat healthy. I like feeling good all the time. I like feeling dialed in. I like my emotions, you know, happy all the time, consistently feeling great. And I just gotten to the point where I don't wanna mess that up anymore. I've learned that I can go out and I can socialize and I can have fun with people without needing it. And I like how much money that I'm saving. I've calculated it that I'm probably you know, saving, you know, anywhere from, you know, about $3,000 to $5,000 a year. Because think about it, if you spend just $50 a week on alcohol over the course of a year, can't think of the number exactly, but I know it's between $2,000 and $3,000. And many times I was spending a lot more than that a week on alcohol. And I think a lot of us that are honest, you know, can admit that, you know, we spend more than that on alcohol. And so I gave myself a $3,000 to $5,000 a year raise just by not drinking alcohol. And, you know, I've noticed my skin looks a lot better. It's made it so much easier for me to, you know, maintain a lean body. I've gotten so much stronger. In my workouts, I do jiu-jitsu. I've noticed that, you know, I perform better. I have better strength. I've always kind of had like an ADD brain. I noticed that I'm able to focus now, you know, where I don't get as distracted as easily. And it used to, like I said before, when I would get these, when I would binge drink on the weekends and things like that, it used to be a game of catch up, you know, and by the, it would take me till like Wednesday or Thursday to get back into that really good peak state. And so I'd only be in like a peak, good, feel good, awesome mental state until, you know, for like a couple days. And then by usually Thursday or Friday, I would break it. And then I'd be drinking all again. A lot of times I would even drink on Wednesday, like as soon as I started to feel good. And so, you know what? I just said, you know what? That's not the way to live. I want to feel good all the time, not just a couple days a week. You know, I want to feel good 7 days a week. And just imagine how much more productive I could become, what I could accomplish. And I've already noticed the benefits tremendously. I'm way more productive than I used to be. Or like I said, on Monday, I was usually still nursing, hangover, and Tuesday. Now, I mean, I'm kicking butt. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, every day of the week, I'm more productive. It's easier for me to eat healthier. Because when you're drinking and you're hungover, a lot of times, you know, your mind is not at its strongest, your willpower and everything is all messed up. So you're more likely to go resort to eating unhealthier foods. But now that I'm dialed in all the time, you know, I don't want anything to mess with it. And so I've learned that, you know, you can still go on dates without alcohol and have a fun time. And I've learned that, you know, you can still go out and go to parties, and you can even go to bars if you want to. The funny thing is I don't even really go out to bars and things like that much anymore. I've kind of lost interest in it. Like, it's just like, you know what? I would rather stay home and read, study, work on myself, self-improve. That way the next day I could get up early. I found enjoyment and highs and getting drunk on life in different ways, like waking up in the morning so I could crush a workout and continue to work in my garden, read, practice, play music. I play the guitar. I've taught myself the harmonica over the past year. Soon I'm going to start learning the piano. And so there's so many other incredible highs that you can get from life, ways that you can get drunk off life without needing alcohol. So, you know what? It's funny. What was kind of an accident in me quitting alcohol has now turned into a lifestyle. And I love it. I don't want to. I have lost all desire to drink alcohol at all. I just don't want it. Why would I want to, you know, drink some poison? You know, I mean, if someone offered you a nice glass of bleach, would you drink it? You know, I'm sure if you drank a glass of bleach in some way or form, it would probably give you a buzz because the poison is so poisonous. And so, no, thank you. You know, I've seen the light. And so most people cringe at just the thought of doing a 30-day challenge without alcohol. In my opinion, it takes even longer than that to rewire your brain. I've done many 30-day challenges in the past without alcohol, and I still would miss drinking alcohol. But the real magic for me happened at, you know, after about, you know, 4, 5, 6 months, where I really created, they say it takes about 30 days to create a habit and 90 days to create a lifestyle. And that's what accidentally happened for me. I didn't realize it, but I had created a lifestyle. I had never gone that long without alcohol since I was, when I first started drinking when I was a kid, 14 years old. And, you know, pretty much from that day and age, I was drinking every single weekend my entire life. And so all of a sudden, when I went those couple of months, I saw the light again. I realized, wow, you know what? I don't need this anymore. And in fact, I'm better off without it. So, I encourage you guys, if you're still drinking, see for yourself. You know, just go 6 months without drinking alcohol so you can get that mindset shift. And if that's too scary for you, then even just go 3 months. Like I said, 30 days is not going to completely change your life, but 90 days can, like it did for happened to me. You create a lifestyle in that 90, something magical happens. You know, in the grand scheme of life, 90 days isn't that long. And I know people always like to, you know, say if you live 80 years old or whatever, you know, 90 days is just a drop in the bucket. And if you already know what it's like to drink all the time, and to, then why not do an experiment? You don't know what it's like to be an adult with the knowledge and wisdom that you have now to go 90 days without alcohol, or 6 months, or a whole year. And then it'll happen is it'll start to illuminate, and you'll start to see the truth. Like I've seen, it's hard to almost even put it into words. And don't worry, you know, people always will say, oh, you know, I got a wedding coming up. Oh, I got this trip with the boys, the girls, you know, this, that, or whatever. And they, you know, there's always going to be something going on. That's just life. So don't use an event that's coming up as an excuse not to do this kind of challenge. Instead, see it as a challenge to be able to still go to that wedding, still go to that party, and have fun without needing it. You know, laugh, challenge yourself to see if you can dance, still flirt and socialize with other people without needing a drink and any alcohol. So with that being said, guys, I hope you have a great day, a great week, a great month, a great year. Let's make it a great life, baby.